What? And oh, duck in the mist! And raking the eye there, and so the ball was there, a head scissors! And now, oh, he's got arms up for the bunter lock! And now the arbiter's in trouble! Caught there now. Pull back and got a close line there. Rolling it up now.
One.
RD, one. Two. Ow. Oh, there, close but no cigar. You see the way the arbiter there was clutching the leg. Was clutching his leg. So what was that? Got to try and exploit that. And he's going to attempt to pick up arbiter. And that's not going to work. Shot right to the face. Oh, they're taking a quick glaze over the ref. Gaze. Sorry, not glaze. Glaze is something you do to a cake. He sees the ball right now. Did he just try to go for the ref? He does that, he'll be disqualified. He hit the KO kick there. Wait a minute. No! Looked like he was going to try for that butter lock again, and oh my word. Nicely done that. The ref down again, and the ref, he's back up. Yeah, we don't have WWE refs who get knocked out easier than... I would insert a reference here, but I don't feel I should. These refs get right back up. Hey, look, it's the Bulman now! Driving the referee with a cockpit! What the hell's that about? And now, ow! Take it off the boom! So Bulma trying to use that big bell! And it's backfired on him! It has backfired big time! And now... a kick right there! And Arbiter now! Goes over for the ref! Picks it up, and now the ref is calling DQ! Arbiter winning by disqualification! Savomi, drive the ref down with the cockpit! Right here it was! He drove the ref! And that's what brought the disqualification! He tries to use the ring bell, that backfires on him! He gets absolutely clobbered! Well, Arbiter, he'll be about to joint fifth Sepulveda. He's kicked himself down to joint last. I mean, this guy couldn't be more of an idiot. Well, regardless, we've only got to see... Oh, wait a minute! Oh, look at this! Zoroark and Reptile! And notice now Zoroark and Reptile going after the ref! Now oh, just drilling the ref on his head! And now this is double teaming the Arbiter! Suburban now back to his feet! You see right now! Oh man, look at- OW! Drilling the Arbiter right on his face! Now, throwing him in the corner. The Republic now just on a 3-on-1 assault. Oh, the pile driver. Spike pile driving him. And now, look at this. Drilling the ref on his head right there. I mean, the Republic, they're assaulting the Arbiter and the referee. I mean, you attacked him, Savoma. You attacked him! You got disqualified! Oh wait, look at this! Oh! I thought the ref there was actually gonna fight back, but... he's quickly taken down again. Oh no, look at this! And the ref now back up to his feet! Arms are getting absolutely planted! And ref now trying to move out of the way. Oh no, but he gets caught right there. He gets caught. Now, oh wait, look at this. The ref there. Actually, oh no. Ow! See, the ref actually was going to fight back on Sabor, but oh, now he's kicked. Now the ref kicked over the top, and oh no. Oh, thrown to the corner. Forward out, shots right to Arbiter's face. And Arbiter right now. Oh, Christ. Oh. Oh. Son of a walk. Oh, right down. The ref now back in the ring. And I'm just dropping in there. And the Republic have just completely laid out the Arbiter, and now they're going back after the ref. I mean, come on now! And the ref trying whatever he can, to fight back. But the numbers right now, are too good. The numbers like that are too great! Oh, and there's that powerbomb down the Republic, laying out both the Arbiter and the referee! And the Republic absolutely playing another victim, but just in disgraceful manner. Absolutely despicable. Seriously, Sabor couldn't have been more of an idiot. He has just knocked himself into joint last with Randy Lee. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, two more matches, and this one's gonna have Silver. And boy oh boy, has Silver had a major drop. He was in the top four before the aftermath, following the Hog Battle Royal. He ended up being eliminated first, scored nothing. And now he's in. Now he's still on 14 points. Anyway, here's the wild one, and this guy's got to be coming off a few rough days. I mean, being in the ring with someone when they have a heart, when they have a severe heart failure, that's got to be somewhat, that's got to have somewhat of an effect on the Wildcat. He may not be showing it, but I've got to imagine it's had some sort of effect. And if it hasn't, then anyway, see right now, nice chop there. You see right now, me going in a sleeper there. And you want to try and, you know, for these guys, I mean, if you look at where they are right now, Wildcat actually isn't too bad. But Silver, he is really going to need this. I mean, he's in joint 8th with JSR behind, ahead of Randy Lee and Sabulba. So he's got a, turn it up. Anyway, Silver right now. He's pinned down and, oh, able to kick out. And thrown to the corner there, you see now. Shots there. And to Silver, really trying to take it to the Wild Wild Bat. And now the most devastating move in CXWI! It gets a two count. You can see right now the shots here. And Wildcat now. Ow! Dropping him there. Of course, for the Wildcat though, scoring a win right here would actually take him temporarily into third place. Considering Skywalker's match later, but we now know he'll have with Austin. And that's going to be one hell of a match. Nicely done there by Silver. And Silver right now. Flash DD. Oh. Silver there taking that. Oh. Nicely done there. And you see right now. Shot there. And Silver. Schoolboy here. Going to use the ropes here for leverage. Two. And oh. Close. But close but no cigar. Now you see here. Oh, goes behind here. One, the most ever seen move in CXWI. Three, he won it! Wildcat got the victory with that one. He scores the backslide cover. The most devastating move in CXWI. And the Wildcat, unusually, wins by pinfall. Here it was. A backslide cover by the Wildcat. And that will take him temporarily into third place. But with our last match between Austin and the Austin and Anakin Skywalker, that could change. Skywalker could jump back into third and close the gap between second and third even tighter if he were to get the victory here. Hell, he could even take over Austin if he were to win by submission. If I know Austin Uaz, he doesn't tap out. He's not one to tap out. If he were to win by KO, he would even the, where he stands right now, he would even the score. He would even joint second. Or he would even second place, excuse me, to create joint second. Anakin Skywalker, gotta assume right now, but he doesn't have anything to worry about elimination-wise. However, you never know. Anyway, Skywalker in, looking ready to go. He's gonna need to be against Austin Uaz. And here is Austin. Austin, since he came here, he's been desperate to be world champion. But he has fallen short at every opportunity. His rivalry with SMCS is what would hold him back for a longer time. No matter what he did, SMCS would be there. SMCS is no longer in CXWI. Austin fought with that, he can turn his attention fully to the world title. And right now he can, but he still has adversity to deal with. Likes of his former best friend, Phil Mean. And his somewhat revenge from Scotland, if you want to call it that, in the form of groundskeeper Willie. Austin Uaz here. And Austin Uaz, he's really gonna want to win by submission if he's gonna be able to really close the gap on Desaad. I'm very sure Austin would love nothing more than to take Desaad down. But he's gonna have Skywalker tonight.